Hi, this is Tom Klein at the World Music Variety Show. And as most of you know, we here at the show take pride in playing some of the best music on the planet that no one has ever heard before. But every now and then, we like to do some actual hard-hitting topical journalism. And that's what we're going to do next, as our world music interview specialist, Joshua Brown, was able to sit down for an interview with the Secretary of Education, Betsy DeVos, to talk about her upcoming plan to reopen schools across America in a pandemic at a time when the coronavirus numbers are skyrocketing. Let's send it out to Joshua.
Thanks, Tom. And thank you for sitting down and talking with me, Madam Secretary.
Thank you for having me, Joshua.
To begin, I wanted to ask you about something you said earlier this week. You said, quote, "There is nothing in the data that suggests that it would be inappropriate to have kids in school. But looking at the data, it's pretty apparent that the number of people who are contracting the virus on a daily basis is almost double what it was when we closed the schools down back in March. And every day it seems like one state or another sets a new record high. And the numbers are clearly going up. In several of these states, the ICUs are either at or near capacity. Knowing all that, can you tell me what your plan is to assure parents that it is safe for them to send their children back to their schools?"
Well, the key is that kids have to get back to school. We know there will be hotspots, and we will deal with those as they arise. But the rule is that kids need to go back to school this fall. They've already missed months of learning. It'll be difficult to catch up. And the truth is, these kids are just dying to go back to school and play with their friends again.
They're dying to go back. Not sure that's the best way to describe it.
Look, these kids need to go back for their health in a multitude of dimensions and a multitude of factors. For their emotional well-being, their mental well-being, and particularly for kids from low-income and vulnerable populations, it is devastating for them to be out of school and not learning for months on end.
Secretary DeVos, I don't think there is anyone who disagrees with that. Obviously, we all want the children in this country to be able to go back to school and for life to go back to being normal again. But I also think we all agree that it must be done smartly and safely. But with the number of virus cases spiking all over the country, I'll ask you again, what is your plan to assure the people listening at home that they can send their kids back to school safely?
Well, first of all, Joshua, as I'm sure you know, you can't actually plan for something that hasn't even happened yet.
Yes, Madam Secretary, you can. It's called a plan. That's kind of exactly what a plan is.
Well, we can agree to disagree on that. And look, we know that children get the virus at a far lower rate than adults do. And there is nothing in the data that we have seen that would indicate that the danger to the children if they go back is more detrimental to their health than if they were to continue to stay home. I mean, having the kids at home all day, every day is driving their parents crazy. It's driving the kids crazy. And so to me, not sending them back to school would obviously just be crazy.
We do know that kids can catch and spread the virus, even if it is at a lower rate than for adults. There was recently a Christian summer camp in Missouri that closed after 82 kids and staff members caught the virus. In Texas, more than 1,300 children and staff members in a childcare facility tested positive. And the CDC's own guidelines warn that children gathering in groups can spread the virus to the more at-risk individuals at home.
The CDC guidelines also say that the way to prevent catching and spreading the virus is good hygiene. Washing your hands, wearing masks when appropriate, social distancing.
Let me interrupt you, Madam Secretary. How are you going to ensure social distancing? The guidelines suggest everyone staying 6 feet apart at a minimum. You can look at the square footage of any classroom or school and see that mathematically, it is not possible to maintain that distance based off the number of children in those classrooms or schools. So how can you possibly maintain that required social distancing?
I was told there was going to be no math in this interview.
And you are the Secretary of Education?
Look, the CDC guidelines are just recommendations. They're not the law. And the bottom line is that we must send our children back to school. If there are flare-ups or hotspots, we will deal with those on a case-by-case basis.
Okay. So, if there is a spike in cases in any school district, what should the schools do? Should they close down and send everybody back home and back to teaching the kids virtually until the crisis has passed?
No. As I said, it is vital to everyone that the children go back to their actual schools.
So you're saying that even if the virus is raging out of control, the kids and teachers need to go back to their schools on the scheduled date?
Yes, for the good of all. And as I said before, if there are flare-ups, we will deal with those.
How?
How? We would come in and beat back the virus.
Again. How? What does "we'll beat back the virus" even mean? There's no known cure or vaccine, so how would you beat it back?
We have the greatest military on the planet.
The greatest military? Seriously? You do realize that you can't beat this virus back with our own military, right?
Well, we don't know that for sure.
Yes, we do. If you could beat this with the U.S. military, we would have bombed this bitch off the face of the planet already.
We still might. You don't know that for sure. Plus, we have the greatest and brightest minds working for us, so whatever we need to do, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. And so, the kids are going back to their schools. And that is that. And if any school doesn't open, we will withhold federal funding from them.
And how will that help anything or anyone?
It is the first step toward returning to where we were before this virus messed everything up, okay? Our great leader, President Trump, made a promise to the people of this country that he would make America great again. And that is what we intend to do. And sending our children back to their schools is the first step in doing exactly just that. As it says in the Bible, the children shall lead them. The children are our future. They are our tributes. And we will watch them with tears in our eyes and pride in our hearts as they lead us into the future.
First, I'm pretty sure that isn't what the Bible says. And secondly, going to school should not be the same thing as Hunger Games. You get that, right? What you're doing is sending them out into a virus-plagued world to potentially die or spread the virus to their families and kill them.
I think you're exaggerating a bit. Our data shows that the number who might die is fairly small. And quite frankly, the casualty numbers that we are looking at are something that both I and the president find acceptable. And so we are reopening, period, for the good of everyone.
Oh my God, we are all going to die. Look, let's wrap this up. Is there any final words that you want to say to the children of America before you send them off to their deaths, Madam Secretary?
Yes. Happy first day of school, children, and may the odds be ever in your favor.
Okay. And on that tragic note, I'm sending it back to you, Tom, in the World Music Variety Hour. Are you?